Hey everyone, Matt Pisarcik from RazorEmporium.com. Today, to continue our journey down the Razor Archive line, doing our series on the history of Gillette Razors.
Pee-wee Reese has a way with Dodger rookies or Sandlot youngsters.
Pee-wee, you do a lot of work with boys.
Not work, Al. I like baseball and kids. I enjoy helping teenagers start right.
Well, that's around shaving age, and you give them pointers on personal appearance, too?
Yes. A boy has more self-respect when he's clean-shaved. I tell him to use a Gillette razor, Al.
You said it. The Gillette Super Speed Razor. And today there are three. Light for sensitive skin in most younger men. Regular for average skin and beard. Heavy for men who like the heft and feel of a heavier razor. Each is different, precisely engineered. One has the right blade edge exposure, edge angle, and weight to shave you in a breeze. Comfortable, good-looking shaves you may never have had before. And convenient, you change blades and rinse clean, so. Choose your Gillette Super Speed Razor. $1.29 with Gillette Blue Blade Dispenser in handy travel case.
So, we're here in the 50s. The year is 1954, and Gillette, for the first time in 50 years of history, is finally acknowledging that there is a difference between men and the way they need to shave and the beard types and skin types, and they come out with this, the Super Speed Trio. This was the first time Gillette really said, okay, I guess there is a difference from one guy to the next, and we probably should have some variations, because up until now, Gillette was marketing the fact that you could loosen the handle on their three-piece razors and kind of get a little spring action from the blade kind of being relaxed, and it would change the blade gap a little bit. They talked about bigger handle if you're a manlier guy, a bigger man with a big fellow. But they really didn't talk about blade exposure or blade angle before. And today, the modern wet shaver is obsessed with blade angle and blade exposure, and that's all we could ever think about, and blade gap, and all these variations. Well, it all starts right here, guys. It starts right here in 1954 with the Super Speed Trio. So, Gillette said that there is going to be a light razor for new shavers, for guys with, a light beard, if they're getting started with shaving. And these razors were going to be denoted by a blue styrene case and a Super Speed head being made of brass and nickel plated, but aluminum handle and a blue powder coated tip. So a little bit lighter in weight. And they also said that the blade exposure on this was a little bit more mild, on the mild side. So the blue Super Speed razor. Then they said we're going to have the regular for normal beard, normal guys, your everyday man. And this was the same kind of blade exposure, blade gap as most of their razors throughout time. And that was what we call today the flare tip Super Speed. There's no tip color, it's just all nickel plated. And instead of aluminum handle, the entire thing's brass, a solid brass razor, a little bit more blade exposure, blade gap on this guy. And it came in a tan case. So there's no such thing as a tan tip razor. These were just nickel plated. And last but not least, the famous red tip heavy Super Speed. Mine even has this little banner down here that says heavy. That's just a little piece of paper that kind of went on the razor sets. And this guy, in comparison to the Super Speed, is a little heavier. It's got a kind of a bigger, chunkier handle. And it has more of a blade exposure and a blade angle. To give a closer shave, and it was meant for guys with a heavy beard or like the heft and feel of a heavier razor. So this was kind of their option for that. Now we call this series the Super Speed Trio. Another name for it in the Krumholtz book would be the pre-adjustables. This razor series went through 1958 or so when the actual adjustable razors came out, and truth be told, Gillette had such a high success with this line of razors, it was so popular that that's why they wanted to have a fat boy adjustable or a toggle adjustable that included kind of these three levels of aggression in one handle. But this razor series, very, very popular. I can't tell you how many times we've restored red tip razors or blue tip razors over the years, or just the regular flare tip Super Speed, and we call them flare tips because the end kind of flares out like this. So one of the only kind of flaws I could think of on these razors would be the powder coat tips. You know, it is a weak point. It's not plating, and it can chip over time and come off. you know, the original Gillette factory finish was a powder coat, pretty durable. But, you know, over time, if people are cleaning these or using a wire brush or abusing them, these can get really discolored. We've done a couple episodes of our other channel, I'd Lather Be Shaving, talking about how to you know, spray paint this back with spray paint. Here in our shop, we actually do have color match powder tip colors that are an exact color match. So you can be rest assured if you send something to us for restoration, it'll have the right color coming back to you. But I've seen all sorts of things. I've even seen someone who wanted this to be done in a green or another color, black, you know, just random colors. But the original colors obviously are kind of a medium blue and kind of a dark maroon red. And these razors were extremely popular for Gillette. This series did so well. And storekeepers loved them. They had these promotional advertisement displays in the stores for customers to see. But then on the back side, they would have all the talking points for the storekeeper to kind of be able to regurgitate and read off and help to sell the tool. This is called point of sale material. And that's exactly what it's designed to do, is to help the person sell the product to the customer. Very interesting period of time. To me, this is kind of the real classic Gillette time period where I really started, when I was a young collector, loving this. The cases, so cool, so unique. They were designed by a German industrial designer. There's such a cool streamlined kind of look, very 50s. I mean, when I see this, I think of, you know, a 57 Chevy, you know, these big muscle cars, you know, the big fins coming off the back, and you push this little button and it opens up. I think it's so cool. Made of styrene. So, very interesting period of time. I would say that on a rarity scale, you know, one, you can find these every time you go out thrifting, versus five, it belongs in a museum. Well, if you just find the razor alone, the blue tip, the flare tip, or the red tip, pretty low on the scale. Maybe one and a half. You know, I won't even put it really past that. Now, if you find it with the case and with blades and with this little piece of paper that says heavy or regular on it, all right, we're going to get up there. We're going to get maybe to 2.5, 3.5. If you find it with the original point of sale material like these racks I have, definitely going to be up there 4, 4.5, 5 out of 5. I've had a lot of people comment on these over the years. I actually picked this myself locally here in Phoenix, Arizona. I found this at a store. It was behind the counter, and my eyes lit up, and I think I paid like $80 for just a piece of metal. Had no super speeds on it. I've had to acquire these over the years and put them on it, but was so excited to see that. I can't remember where I got these. I think these were either trades or eBay finds, but a very cool piece of history. Really kind of classic Gillette marketing. This was when Gillette was leading the pack, as always. The competitors had nothing on them. They were clearly the dominant juggernaut of the razor world. So thank you guys so much for watching. If there's something about the Super Speed Trio that I missed, leave a comment. And if you do, you're entered in to win this, the official Razor Emporium black and blue t-shirt. And we're so grateful for you guys to check out our channel today and subscribe, you know, share a video with a friend, and we'll see you next time here at Razor Emporium for all things vintage shaving.